Hey guys, XTrefWolf Gaming here. I am recording episode 3 of FTB Genesis. As of now, we are going to be collecting all of this. Love it. As of now, we're going to be doing selective breeding, I believe. So we'll just throw everything in here and there. Mushroom stew. I'll actually eat that. Sweet. I feel so comfortable. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Hold on. What was that? I never got seed. It looked different. Oh, I see now. Ooh, me likey. This is a birch cabinet, but it's called drive storage. Anyway, whoa. Wait. Oh, these like straight like. Oh, there's a sliding door. I didn't even realize that. These blocks are actually made specifically for this. That's kind of cool. Okay, so we have stuff. Magical. Okay. Look in here. Oh, we got drinks, food, plenty of hemp seed. Oh, we got kelp, beehives, and looms. I don't. Wait, is this different? No, it's rose. This is an enchanting book. Fertilizer, I'll take that. A bed. Frank. Can I carry Frank? No. We have a place to sleep though. Hello, Frank. Okay, I'm Dr. Lara Thorne, and the story of my greenhouse is one of persistence, innovation, and the subtle art of coaxing new life from the earth. My early days as a botanist were marked by the disheartening sight of my plants either spreading thin, growing at a painfully sluggish pace, or succumbing to the silence of death. It was clear that my initial approach lacked finesse. My plants were like children lost in the dark. They needed light, the first whisper of dawn, to thrive. It was when I tailored the environment to ensure each species received the luminescence it so desperately craved. Yet light was only part of the equation. Some of my botanical children, despite their newfound brightness, began to brown. Their verdant hues fading to dry crinkle of neglect. They thirsted, and no amount of water nearby would suffice. It was in hydration cells that I found salvation. These small vessels of life-sustaining moisture became their consistent companions, releasing water at a pace that mimicked the natural hydration of the most nourishing rainfalls. With light and water now in harmony, I turned to the soil itself. It needed enrichment, so I ventured into the realm of fertilizers. And the surprising efficacy of wheat seeds. This combination was the final key, unlocking a vigor in my plants that I had only dared to dream of. But my true ambition was to create something new, to forge a legacy of biodiversity. My initial attempts at crossbreeding were chaotic, a wild dance of genes that refused to follow my lead. It was only when I established order, planting them in long rows of three, with middle row dedicated to the breeding process, that I managed to coax the stubborn genetics into the patterns I sought. With the help of a crop analyzer, any device that I could simply shift right click on the plants with, I could immediately see the fruits of my labor, understanding the new breed with a mere touch. Starting with Stickreed, the patience and precision paid off. Each new species was a victory, a green flag planted in the soil of my domain. My ambition grew alongside my plants, and soon I was cultivating netherwort, from which I bred tarawort and the elusive red wheat. Each success the stepping stone, the grander creations. But I did not stop there. Blue wheat emerged, a triumph of color and cultivation. Then, with careful manipulation and a bit of botanical alchemy, I achieved the unimaginable. Crops that yielded not just food, but metals and gems. They were my crowning glory and a testament to the potential locked within seeds and soil. My greenhouse became a place of wonder, where the boundaries of nature were pushed and redefined. As a botanist, I had become not just a caretaker, but a creator of life, a sculptor of the living, breathing earth. What? That's up here. Sculptor of living, next, breathing earth. Do you mean breathing life? No, you're creator of life. Breathing earth! And thus, the legacy of Dr. Alara Thorne grew intertwined the roots of her extraordinary children. And she had a cockroach named Frank, who has now left the binds of the housing unit and lies somewhere in wait. Somewhere. Maybe he left. I don't know. I don't. Oh, come on! Auto jump. Always killing my plants. I don't know where the exit is. There we are. Okay. So, my job. I don't know my job yet. I'm looking for selective breeding, right? Yes. I need selective breeding and synthetic acquisitions. Oh, okay. The crop analyzer can do much more than just identify the. Wait, hold on, wait. No. First, let me figure out where I'm going. Because that's where I figure out what I'm marking. I also forgot to select check. I mean, chapter will take you on obtain rubber. Synthetic acquisitions will also help with this. Okay, so I need to obtain rubber. I need to obtain rubber. RN Jesus, take the wheel. Powered by Java. Oh, coffee seeds. What gets me rubber? Synthetic acquisitions part of this? Okay. What path am I taking? I don't see rubber, but maybe rubber looks different from. Okay, that'll yield iron. Red wheat. I think it wants me to make stick reed, doesn't it? Oh, sticky resin! Oh my god. First, the most important crop you'll want to work towards breeding is the stick reared. This place. Easiest way to. The easiest way you breed crops is by placing three crop sticks in a row and placing another crop stick on the middle one to create a breeding spot. Grow crops on the outer side. You want to serve a crossbreeding sugarcane. Okay. So, let's not this way. This is gonna be something. So I want resin. And because it's a thing I can do, it's a thing I can do in the background, so might as well do it. I was kind of just throwing everything underwear. So I want this. I want sugarcane. What does the overgrowth seed do? Crop analysis too. And I also need to grow. Right. I mean, I think I saw breeding areas, but I'm taking these just in case. Yeah, right here is the breeding area. They didn't place this one in the same place. How does this work? Oh. I completed it. I think I have a battery now, or something. Hold on, wait. Let me reread that again. In a row. Three crop sticks in a row. Breeding spot, breeding spot, breeding spot, breeding spot, breeding spot, breeding spot. But I be fertilizing. Be careful. Okay, so next, can I? Or do I? That works. Well, seems the fertilizer does make things grow. Oh, you can actually fill them up on fertilizer. Sorry, I don't think I'm supposed to be harvesting this. No. Right here. Oh, I walked forward. I got distracted by something. Where am I? Here? Here. Sure. I don't know what I'm doing per se. Am I supposed to be putting like new sugarcane in here? No, okay. So how does this work? Okay, so just eventually they'll have a new plant. Frank, I found you. I kind of want to kill Frank. I'm just saying. This isn't what I think it is it? Frank is a woman. I shouldn't. I'm killing them. No, go back here. I didn't recognize the word. I never heard it before. I never should have thrown it. I not heard it, seen it. You. Frank? Frank, I refuse to let you live. Did something grow? I got a quest called Happy Plants. I got two more now. Okay, that's a breeding spot. That's an unknown crop. Saw that. Right there. That's one. Alright. Unless there were more babies. I shouldn't have to deal with roaches. I was fine when it was just one, but if it had a child, I needed to kill all of them. Where is it that time? It is! I get to have my first sleep! Since I'm doing this like a chapter at a time, I think I'm gonna name them after what I've done. Maybe. This is sugar cane. Sugar cane. Sugar cane. Sugar cane. Oh, okay, I just. Sugarcane. Is any of this not sugarcane? So what I'm thinking is, this is gonna take a while, so I'll pause until I get some kind of results. I missed one. We are now growing a brown mushroom. So, yeah, that's that. All right, I'll be back. We have another contender. We will now be scanning. This be cactus. Okay, all right. Yeah, I'll be back. Wait, hold on, is this another crop? It is. Oh, I'm not carrying our thing. Sea pickle. Interesting. Let's take one look around. For. Yeah, all right, I'll be back. So we got two unknown crops. Sugarcane. I think it's also sugarcane. Yes. Is there one more? This is also sugarcane, but. Oh. Hold on, give me a sec. All right. Yeah, I thought so. Our brown mushrooms and our cactus is grown. Sugarcane's getting out of hand. All right, I'll be back. Okay, some progress. We have something new. It's a tulip. We have grown a tulip. Okay. And before we check out, another crop. Okay. We have grown wheat. And another one. A dark oak sapling. Sugarcane. Okay. Dark oak. Pumpkin. Okay. Interesting. Alright, I think that's it for the new ones. I'll be back. Jungle sapling. Oak sapling. dark oak sapling. This is something. This doesn't look like. We got a berry bush. And we also got another oak sapling over there. Pink tulip over here. It's very interesting. We got bamboo. I suspect berry bush. There it is. Dandelion. We got tea. We have red mushroom. Berry bush. Acacia. Red mushroom. Blue orchid. More wheat. Melon. Potato. Another cactus. Beetroot. Purple tulip. We have rid ourselves some hemp. We got cocoa, birch, hops, whatever those are, blackthorn. We got it. We have stick reed. Oh my god. That's just sugarcane. Oh my god, so much work. Every single one of those kept on being some every single one of those kept on being some kinda sugar cane. And I'm mostly sure we have another one. Okay. I feel like because of how long that took, if it looked because of how long that took, I actually may have gotten it earlier, but I accidentally passed by it because when I scanned it, it looked exactly like. Okay, this keeps growing in like seconds. It looked exactly Like sugarcane. And when I was growing sugarcane, I decided to just break it. And early on, I wasn't even trying to frickin' put sugarcane or scan sugarcane, so I kept just breaking sugarcane because it looked like sugarcane. And then when the tree started popping up, I realized that things can look like other things. So I decided to stop breaking the sugarcane. Oh. Oh. Beauty. We have now achieved sticky resin. Let's do that. Trigger a couple of things. Stick read. Grow it. Okay, next. Okay, and the bamboo in here. I should have the hemp, right? Yeah. Okay, so let's just do that. Cactus, the valley, bamboo, beetroot, cactus, wheat. Maybe I can snow block. Okay. Okay, no, the one next to it. Submit. No, it's not dead yet. So I just realized this entire time I could have been growing Stickreed a lot earlier. Now I'm annoyed. Anyway, what was it that I needed to grow? I needed to grow. Okay, so what I need is that, and I need this. Okay. Oak sapling, filter, hemp, sure. So if I'm lucky, so we got hemp there. Tea. Wait, what? Seed. This sucks. I only ever got like see. Well, oh, breed tea or hops. Oh, I have hops growing. I can. Where is that? Can I recharge the battery? Lot of sugar cane.
be back.
Okay, so inadvertently while attempting to get the seeds for the hops, I got Pharaoh. So that's something. So, yeah, I'll get back to it. I also made something called Stanum. So that's fun. The seeds have in fact been achieved. Okay. Now, maybe eventually that will grow into a full tree or something. Not a tree. Into coffee. Of acceptable, purified, and regular. What's it in? Oh, yeah, this. So, yeah. We've now achieved Rhubarb. Now let's switch to the feather thing. Be precise. I feel like since this is just going, I have to use it. I don't know how much rubber it wants me to get. It said they just go until I could get rubber. Oh, I can go onto a dangerous path now. Okay. Then... what? That was weird. Okay, so... that's it for this episode of FTB Genesis. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like. Subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye.